Hi everyone, CEDIA Awards coming up soon. Doing a short clip. Stay tuned, 35 degrees, 9 o'clock in the morning. Practicing all day. Speak to you soon.
Hit it!
That's what I'm talking about.
Wait!
Okay now, from the beginning.
Hit it, boy.
Welcome to the 2020 CEDIA Awards. And now, almost live, definitely global, and maybe a little tipsy already, your hosts, Wendy Griffiths and Paul Skelton.
Hello, and welcome to the 2020 CEDIA Awards. Tonight we honour the best of the best, the finest work our CEDIA membership has to offer. I'm Wendy Griffiths, CEDIA's Vice President of Engagement and Global Development.
And I'm Paul Skelton, CEDIA's Regional Development Consultant for Australia and New Zealand. 2020 has certainly been a strange year, from devastating bushfires that ravaged the eastern states of Australia, through to a global pandemic that's seen different levels of restrictions imposed across the various countries, states and territories in the region.
I would love to be with you there celebrating tonight, but of course international travel restrictions have made that impossible. So I'm pleased to be joining you virtually. I hope you have a fantastic evening.
I would also love to be with you all tonight, but I live in Victoria, which of course means that I'm less welcome in some parts of Australia than Pete Evans and his activated nuts. But through the magic of green screen and technology, Wendy and I could be anywhere.
For example, I could be in Australia enjoying a few drinks with you all, as I have in previous years.
We could even be in Japan. Just not Queensland.
Moving right along, tonight we're here to highlight the best of the smart home technology integration projects in the Asia Pacific region for 2020. We will find out who won what, who raised the bar to new and exciting heights, and we'll have some cocktails. Our finalists and some special guests from the design and build community and the media have kindly been provided wine by our sponsor, Convoy International. And for the non-finalists, we have some great drinks recipes to share with you. We've created these specially for the event, so fill your glasses and join us in the celebrations.
That's right, Wendy. Why would we let the fact that we can't be together in the same room stop us from doing what this industry does best? And speaking of what we do best, tonight we're going to be telling you about some people in our industry who have done some tremendous things during a very strange year. People from our industry who have pivoted their businesses to help others during the bushfires and the COVID-19 pandemic. These stories show what it means to be CEDIA strong. And with a few words on that very subject, here's Tabitha O'Connor, CEDIA's CEO and Global President.
Welcome everyone, and thanks for joining us. I'd just like to take a moment to thank all of you, the worldwide CEDIA membership, for the ways you've come together and supported one another this year. It's exactly why we began the campaign called CEDIA Strong. We needed a rallying point and a resource for connection and knowledge. You took advantage of that opportunity, and we saw record engagement from the CEDIA universe. We've never been more proud of the resources, the educational offerings, and the benefits we're able to offer. There's more to come. We've got quite a bit in the works to help support you as the global economy starts to recover. Check your email, check our social media feeds, and most importantly, keep checking CEDIA.net for updates. What's truly amazing about this year? CEDIA members have continued to turn out award-winning work, and it's great that we're all able to share those accomplishments tonight. For more on that, please welcome CEDIA's Chairman of the Board, Rob Sutherland.
Thanks, Tabitha. The CEDIA Awards are simply put the perfect illustration of the best of what our industry does. Each year, the CEDIA Awards are judged by a panel of experts from inside the industry and by a team of people from the design and build disciplines too. Tonight, we'll honour the men and women who create amazing experiences for their clients. And we'll honour the manufacturers who help make that experience possible. Thanks to everyone who entered, congratulations to those nominated, and good luck to each of our nominees.
We'll begin tonight's show with the 2020 Awards for Best Home Cinema. Brought to you by one of our sponsors, Bowers & Wilkins.
Hi, I'm John Martin from Bowers & Wilkins, Australia. We're proud to be sponsoring the CEDIA Awards Home Cinema categories for the Asia Pacific region in 2020. This year, there has been some outstanding work by some very talented integrators from across the region. Congratulations to all the finalists. There were no entries in the Level 1 category in 2020, so let's start with Level 2. The finalists for Best Home Cinema Level 2 are Xena Private Theatre from China, with their project Beijing Mijie Theatre, and a cinema called Electric Dreams from the Digital Picture Queensland, Australia. And the winner of the Best Home Cinema Level 2 is Electric Dreams from the Digital Picture in Queensland, Australia.
After the discovery process with the client, the Digital Picture presented an estimate that was three times the original budget. The team was convincing, ultimately building a 9.1.4 system that delivers reference quality sound while being completely hidden from view. There's a unique rack solution at work here too. A 4K projector that delivers a brilliant image to a 158-inch screen, a custom user interface, careful power management, and the dark, elegant aesthetics, including that terrific Starfield ceiling, are all part of this winning project. CEDIA's judges were very impressed with this room's performance.
Thank you, CEDIA, for presenting us with the award for Best Home Cinema this year. It really means a lot to myself and especially my team for all of the hard work they've put in over the last 12 months. I really am the sort of person who strives for perfection in what we do, and it means a lot to them to be able to present this sort of work at this level and actually get recognised for it. It means a lot. Thank you very much.
Let's pause for one of our custom cocktails. After all, it's a celebration.
Good evening, my name is Tom. We're at Bears and Tails in Bedford, and for the first drink of the evening, we're going to be making for Bowers and Wilkins is Diamonds Are Forever. Once again, start with a nice cold glass, which we're going to add a little bit of soda water to. The drink then begins with Beefeater London Dry Gin, flavoured with some vanilla essence. Citrus element comes from fresh lime, sweetened just a touch by sugar. To give some texture, we have some double cream and the white of an egg. That all then gets a little dry shape without ice, just to incorporate all the ingredients. Before we add a big lot of cubed ice and shake it like mad. This then gets poured on top of the soda water. A straw, and we're finishing it with falling silver pearls. And that, for Bowers & Wilkins, is Diamonds Are Forever.
Thanks, Tom. And on behalf of B&W, congratulations to all the winners and finalists. Enjoy your Diamonds Are Forever. Cheers.
Now let's move on to Best Home Cinema Level 3. Back to John Martin from Bowers & Wilkins.
We'll move right to the winner in this category. Recognition is in order for McCormick Concepts of New South Wales, Australia, for their project called the Oracle Cinema.
The client for the Oracle Cinema was particularly focused on audio, and McCormick Concepts delivered on all counts, achieving THX reference level audio for both rows of seats, 85 decibels with 105 dB peaks. Carefully placed speakers, subwoofers, and amplification deliver outstanding immersive sound. A 4K projector and screen coupled with the perfect video processor ensure that the image is of an exacting standard. Well done, McCormick Concepts.
On the behalf of McCormick Concepts, we are thrilled to accept the CEDIA Award for Best Home Cinema Asia Pacific. We'd like to thank our team for their dedication and all their hard work. And another thank you for Cogworks for the design and engineering. We'd also like to congratulate all the other finalists. Thank you.
This is the first CEDIA Award for Chris McCormick and the team at McCormick Concepts, based in the Upper North Shore suburbs of Sydney. The team also enlisted another CEDIA member, Wave Train Cinemas, to help with the design of this cinema. Congratulations to the entire team.
Coming up in the 2020 CEDIA Awards, more cocktails, more trophies, and this year's Lifetime Achievement Award recipient. But first, let's hear from some of the nominees.
We enter the CEDIA Awards every year, mainly because it's great to have our work measured against the best of our peers. There's not any other real places in our industry for us to see how the quality of our work can be benchmarked against everyone else in the industry. And that's not just Australia, but across the world. There are so many excellent companies doing some fantastic work, and it's really good to know that our work is up there with some of the best.
We've invested in CEDIA ever since the beginning in 1995 because we believe that CEDIA continues to set the standards that our industry should strive to achieve.
We entered the CEDIA Awards for our team. We do it to highlight the amazing and precise job they can deliver working all together. But most of all, we enter to reward them. When we win a CEDIA Award, there is a true feeling of pride from the team, knowing they compete with the best and that they are one of them.
The CEDIA Awards elevates our company because it shows our clients, our design and construction partners, that we are among the best in the industry and we are doing excellent work.
We've been to a few of the awards dinners now, and every time Steve and I come away buzzing with new ideas of things that we could do better.
That's all based on what we see from our peers and how they do things. CEDIA Awards give everyone a chance to see how they can raise the bar.
I believe that the CEDIA Awards really help to elevate the entire industry, maybe even the entire building industry from a certain perspective, because their rigorous inspection of best practices and documentation just reverberates with everybody and really resonates with sort of our elite idea of professionalism and the industry partners and things like that. So if you've never participated in the awards program before, I would strongly encourage you to do so. Putting in a winning submission can really help to elevate your game, elevate your team, and also a little friendly competition amongst peers never hurts, right?
The CEDIA Awards have been a great form of promotion for our business. We've only been members for a very short time, but to be able to leverage the awards and to showcase some of our winning projects to new builders and new clients has been a great way to attract new business.
We often refer to our awards when we meet new clients and we're proposing new projects. It's definitely given us recognition throughout the world. And we believe CEDIA is setting the standard and the benchmark for others to follow.
We've always seen CEDIA Awards as the top of the pack. The competition is tough, means that we have to be our absolute best, helping to improve and develop as a company.
Now we'll move to Best Media Room, and we'll start with Level 1. We'll get right to the winner in this category, and it's turning into a very good night for the digital picture. They're our winner for this category for a project dubbed The Bunker. This is the second award of the night for the Gold Coast-based team at the Digital Picture, helmed by home theatre engineer Scott Sauer, who is a THX and HAEA certified integrator. The Digital Picture previously won this category way back in 2014. Congratulations again to the Digital Picture.
This client loves to rock, and the concert sound that this room produces when the speakers and screens are full of old videos is something. The volume won't bother the neighbors as the sound isolation here is second to none, hence the name. A custom screen ensures that the image will be perfect to support viewing of sporting events, too. Congrats to the Digital Picture.
Thank you so much, CEDIA, for presenting us with the award for Best Media Room this year. An immense amount of work went into this project. We were given a blank slate by the client for which to work from, and we were able to deliver something truly exceptional. I want to give a big shout out to our client for giving us the opportunity to put such a sensational system together for them. It's really been a fun ride this year. Thank you.
And this is looking to be a great night for the team from the Digital Picture. Congratulations once again.
What say we hear from a few knowledgeable CEDIA stalwarts now, shall we? Let's get some tips, tricks, and tidbits with some legendary pros in the business.
What I love about this business is that we, as small businesses and entrepreneurs, we get to shape a global industry ahead of all the big boys. So here is to you, innovators, entrepreneurs, let's make WOW the standard in homes of today and tomorrow, together.
So the best piece of advice that I got was about 20 years ago. Hey Steve, I know you were right. I know they're wrong. I know they screwed up your work. I know they made it impossible to finish. But keep smiling, stay friends, because you want to work with these people again and again and again over the next few years. Don't have a fight, better to be happy than right.
I think the best advice I ever received was to surround yourself with brilliant people. There will inevitably be times when you don't know quite what the answer should be, but if you're surrounded by brilliant people, the answer will be there in amongst them somewhere.
The best piece of advice I ever got was that leave 10 bad jobs and pick one good job. It'll give you 10 good jobs again. One good job for a client, and that happy client will become your promoter without spending a penny.
For too many people in this industry, their ability to sell something exceeds their ability to deliver it. Do not overpromise and underdeliver. It's really easy to describe something amazing and not be able to do it. That is without a doubt the simplest way to get into trouble on a project.
I think the quickest way into trouble is to try and cheat or take shortcuts. They inevitably will catch you up one way or the other. So just do the job properly. Think about the job you've got at hand, design things properly, and it'll make the whole project go much easier and it'll be a much more reliable project.
I'm supposed to tell you guys what's the easiest way to get into trouble in a project. And I think that would be sleeping with the owner's wife, but I don't think this has to do anything with it. So what I would like to say is that we should enjoy what we do. I think our job is fun and is privileged, and we should try to enjoy it as much as we can. For all I know, we could be selling shoelaces for a living. Think about that.
Next, the category for Best Media Room Level 2. Get ready for an experience as we introduce you to the winner of this category, the Bespoke Art Deco Media Room from Boutique AV, Melbourne, Australia.
Boutique AV took the wishes of the homeowners, combining his desire for three big screens that could operate independently and her love of beautiful Art Deco finishes, and combined them all into this masterpiece. CEDIA's judges noted immediately that this media room, with its fantastically intuitive user interface, invisible audio delivery, and brilliant, pun intended, lighting solutions, was, as they put it, super creative. Solutions here include remote monitoring of the gear and sound isolation that never compromised this heritage-listed home.
Yes!
Good job, team. Good job. Good job, guys.
What?
That's awesome. That is awesome. Yes. Wow, great new CEDIA. This is Ruben Rigo, Director of Boutique AV, thanking first and foremost the clients so much for the ability to create this masterpiece in their home. Secondly, thanking our amazing team. These guys work hard. They do everything that they need to do to create absolute perfection, and I am so proud of them. And lastly, CEDIA, on behalf of the whole team, we thank you for acknowledging our abilities and awarding us on this awesome project. With that being said, this is Boutique AV saying cheers to you, CEDIA. Cheers.
Cheers.
Led by Ruben Rago, this is the first time Boutique AV have entered the CEDIA Awards, and they have certainly made an impact thanks to their impeccable documentation and video production skills, allowing them to show off the project. Congratulations, Ruben, Boutique AV, and the entire ROR group for their win. During the pandemic, a number of CEDIA firms have gone above and beyond when it comes to being CEDIA strong. We'll be featuring just a few of the people who helped out during the challenges. First up, a firm from Houston, Texas, who went all out to help create and distribute masks in their towns. Here's Pamela Cortez from Echo Workshop.
Hi, I'm Pamela Cortez with Echo Workshop in Houston, Texas, and I've got my amazing assistant Kelsey with me today. We're here today to share our story on how we helped our community during COVID. It started off with my friend Becky. She's part of a quilting bee And instead of making quilts, they started making masks to help the local hospitals, as well as even for essential workers. I reached out to her to see how we could help, and it was almost perfect timing because they were running low on fabric. I reached out to the interior designers that we work with and asked them for any remnants of 100% cotton that they have, and within about a week's time, we filled up my SUV and started helping making masks. I'm gonna pass it over to Kelsey. She's gonna share on how the masks were made and all the benefits to them.
Yep. So this is what they look like. Different fabric, different masks. They're made up of mainly four main components. We've got your two ties here. You've got your front piece of fabric as well as the back piece of fabric. The nice thing that we did was use two totally different types of fabric on each side, just so that you could remember which side you were using to cover your face with. They also have this nice little pocket on the inside so that you could fit your N95 mask inside of it. At the time that we were making these, and we were making them for the medical workers that were all on the other floors other than the COVID floors.
Right.
So the N95 masks were really scarce at the time. So that's why the little pocket was really convenient for them, so that they could find something that they could fit inside of it. But yeah, it's mainly...
it's also washable.
Yeah, also washable, 100% cotton fabric, less irritating to your skin.
Got the long ties.
Long ties, so that you can put it either tie it around your ear like this, or you can take it and tie it all the way around your head like the nurses back there. Most of them had it like that because their ears were just getting irritated from the other masks. But pretty much what we would do is just cut the fabric into the dimensions that you needed. We would starch them and iron them just so that they were a lot faster to run through the sewing machine. And once we got all the pieces put together, we gave them a quick wash and then they were ready to go out to the workers.
So we're just asking everyone to stay safe, stay well, and mask up.
Now let's move on to Best Showroom. We've got a winner in the showroom category that really does quite a lot in a diminutive space. Congratulations to Australia's Wildlife for their Melbourne Experience Centre.
This 100 square metre space has been designed to show off residential tech to both end users and the design build community. Wildlife decided to collaborate with a lot of nearby partners like architects, interior designers, cabinet makers, light suppliers, and so on to build on relationships and leveraged their industry contacts too. This showroom, built for roughly $120,000, has given the firm an ROI of $1.2 million since it was completed just over a year ago. CEDIA's judges said this project was, quote, a lot packed into a small space and done very, very well.
Hey everyone, I'd like to thank CEDIA for this fantastic award. I'm so grateful and appreciative to even being considered as a finalist for this category. We thank you so much. None of this would have been possible though without the hard work and dedication of my team. I'm so proud of the results they've achieved. I'd also like to congratulate all the other finalists across all the other categories and regions. Lastly, I'd also like to congratulate CEDIA for this amazing effort that they've put into to make this event possible during these challenging times. So thank you again. I'm looking forward to catching up with you all in person in the future.
A CEDIA member for just 2 years, John Wilkinson and the team at Geelong-based Wildlife has delivered a spectacular result here for its Control 4 certified showroom. More recently, the company has been contracted to work on the restoration of the Geelong Orphan Asylum and Common School. Built in 1854, the heritage-listed orphanage and school will be converted into two luxurious homes while maintaining the original structure. I'm sure this is a project and company we'll hear a lot about in the future.
You're watching the 2020 CEDIA Awards. Coming up, the big ticket items, best integrated home trophies. We'll also hear from another firm that went above and beyond during the pandemic.
We enter the CEDIA Awards to showcase our team's work. Entering awards drives us to keep improving and pushing the envelope to be the best we can be as a company.
There's no other place that we know of in the world where your work can be judged by the top people in the industry, what they're looking at, and know exactly how to spot the difference between projects. So a win from CEDIA, it means everything to us.
It feels great, both on an individual standpoint and as a collective, as a team. We spend quite a bit of time and a lot of man hours both procuring information, creating and designing.
Doing all that stuff there.
And making things look pretty.
Yeah.
To be nominated for a CEDIA Award, especially in the toughest category with our fellow integrators, the Best Integrated Home Asia Pacific, is a great accolade for our business. It puts us on a stage where we're recognised for all the hard work that we do. I think being involved in the CEDIA platform really just allows us to have good people and good people around us.
We're really proud to be nominated for an award with CEDIA. It elevates our business to a new level, and it's good to be recognised within our industry.
Well, it does feel good for us as an organisation, because we feel that all the time that we had spent had been paid off. CEDIA Awards helps us in elevating our business process to do things much better going forward, while maintaining standards and examples to set.
It's a great honour to be nominated for the CEDIA Awards. We're immensely proud that our work stands out amongst us talented peers.
We believe the CEDIA Awards elevate our business by showing that our work is recognised to be of the standard required to be a CEDIA Award finalist. This builds confidence with interior designers, architects and homeowners.
At Kantara, we've been fortunate enough to have won a few awards from CEDIA over the years. And each year it's special for us. It's a moment for us to take just a little bit of a pause and reflect on the quality of work that we get to do for our clients and in this industry.
Now let's look at some really big projects. It's time to hand out the awards for Best Integrated Home. Our Level 1 finalists are brought to you by CEDIASTRONG Australia.
What would you like your home to do for you? Awaken you. Comfort you. Entertain you. And give you peace of mind, no matter where you may be. Bring your idea of home to life with CEDIASTRONG Home.
Hi, I'm Dee Bubeck of CEDIASTRONG ANZ, and we are delighted to be sponsoring the Integrated Homes category for the CEDIA 2020 Awards Asia Pacific Region. This year, there's been some phenomenal work by some extremely talented integrators from across the region. So congratulations to all of the finalists. Let's get straight to it. The finalists for Best Integrated Home Level 1 are Hobson's Bay by Argus Technologies of Victoria, Australia, and Les Palmas by Electronic Living of Queensland, Australia. And the winner for Best Integrated Home Level 1 is
Argus Technologies for Hobson's Bay. Argus Technologies handled literally every aspect of this home that involved power, even the electrical system, in this knockdown rebuild project. Audio distribution includes 5 zones with wiring for 5 more, and there are 4 zones of video. Other features include robust networking, lighting, security, and a very challenging HVAC integration solution developed by Argus in conjunction with the builder. This project incorporates a lot of cool details, including a voice that announces "dinner's ready" to the kids in their study at the appropriate time via a one-button control panel touch.
It's fantastic to be able to accept this award on behalf of Argus Technologies. This Port Davis home was an 18-month journey for the business and one of the first homes in Australia to demonstrate full integration between Control 4 and a Brivers climate system. My biggest thank you is to our lead techs, Jordan and James, whose hard work on site has helped bring about this award. Your dedication to the job is certainly very much appreciated by myself and the client. A thank you to Brivers and Chalmain Drivers, who helped collaborate with us to bring to market our Brivers Control 4 driver for HVAC integration. And lastly, thank you to CEDIA, the judges and the awards team, for all the hard work that's gone into this very different event this year. Thank you very much.
Argus Technologies is no stranger to the awards circuit, having previously won 3 CEDIA Awards, 2 Master Electricians Australia Excellence Awards, including one for a 4-storey houseboat, and a total of 7 NECA Excellence Awards. congratulations, Robert Erpis, Dean Belton, and the entire team at Argus Technologies. Cheers. Well done, everyone. Now let's check in with another firm that's proven itself to be CEDIA strong. When the COVID-19 pandemic arrived in the Southern Hemisphere, New Zealand wasted no time in ordering a full lockdown. To many, this seemed like a draconian measure, but ultimately it proved effective and New Zealand became a shining example to the world on how to deal with coronavirus. One local CEDIA member, the audiophile, also responded quickly and began working with primary food suppliers installing technical solutions that would allow important food resources to continue to be distributed around the country. Let's hear from the audiophile's manager, Daniel O'Connell, about this important work.
Here we are in Nelson, sunshine capital of New Zealand. Port Nelson is the largest fishing port in Australasia and home to New Zealand's two largest fishing companies. I'm Daniel O'Connell from the audiophile. Today I'm here to share a story on how we supported Westfleet, a seafood industry leader during COVID-19. On the 25th of March 2020, New Zealand went into a full lockdown. This meant only essential businesses were able to operate under strict guidelines. All other businesses could only operate if they could do so remotely. Prior to the COVID-19 hitting our shores, Westfleet were looking into renovating the CEO's office and upgrading their AV system. The COVID-19 pandemic made us rethink the whole design. The system requirements had changed. They needed a more flexible command center with the ability to integrate the operating systems to all the Westfleet sites. We installed an easy-to-use video conferencing system between their sites, giving the CEO the ability to communicate remotely and effectively all his key staff. This allowed Westfleet to continue operating during the lockdown without disruption. We worked in closely with Nelson Alarms to integrate the CCTV and access control system. This provided a seamless system that was extremely easy to use. The project was important to Westfleet. Westfleet is a prime food supplier of seafood throughout Australasia. It was vital that the business kept operating to ensure the continuous production of essential food supply during this crucial time. Having the ability to communicate quickly and effectively between offices and factories meant there were no delays in production and delivery chain. We did require plenty of forward planning with social distancing, making it difficult to work in small environments with multiple technicians required at one time. We had a great feedback from the CEO and the staff of Westfleet of how easy the system was to use. This has given the ability to work remotely without having to travel to sites as frequently, but still have face-to-face interaction. Along with the video conferencing system in the CEO's office, we've integrated and installed automated Lutron blinds, lighting, doors, and heating and cooling systems. We supplied and installed a 3x3 video wall that has access to all of Westfleet's CCTV sites, video conferencing, Sky TV, Apple TV, PC, and ClickShare. The system is managed by an RTI control system that has voice control via Alexa, making the system extremely easy for the CEO to operate.
Back to our Best Integrated Home Awards. Here's Dee Bubeck from Crestron Australia.
The finalists for Best Integrated Home Level 2 are Advanced Hilltop Living by Boutique AV of Melbourne, Australia, Floating House by Bridge Automation, Sanctuary Bay by Bridge Automation of Queensland, Australia, Stratton by Bridge Automation, Beach Point by Electronic Living of Queensland, Australia, and Forever Home with a View by West Coast Hi-Fi of Joondalup, Western Australia. Now, one of these entries was of such high quality that it has been given the highly commended award. So congratulations go to
Electronic Living for Beach Point.
But the winner of Best Integrated Home Level 2 is
Boutique AV for Advanced Hilltop Living. Here's a sample of what the CEDIA judges had to say about this project. Excellent documentation with intuitive, easy-to-use manuals that are critical in this type of installation. You know the cliche, a picture is worth a thousand words? This video is worth more than we could ever say. What a presentation from Boutique AV.
Another one.
Yes!
Here we are again, CEDIA. This is Ruben Rigo, director of Boutique AV. Like the team said, another one. So grateful to accept this award, so grateful to be a part of the association, and so grateful that you guys can acknowledge industry professionals such as ourselves and make such a special moment for us to be able to celebrate tonight. With that being said, we'd like to raise our glasses again and cheers to you, CEDIA. Cheers.
Cheers.
Another huge congratulations to ROR founder and media mogul in the making, Ruben Rego, and the team at Boutique AV for its second award of the night. The Victorian ROR Group comprises companies spanning the residential and commercial installation and video production sectors. Congratulations again, Boutique AV. Now who's up for more advice from our CEDIA colleagues? Let's have a listen.
In the heat of the moment during a client discovery meeting, it can be sometimes a little bit tricky to come up with really, really great and insightful questions to ask your customer so you can dig deep into their needs to come up with the right solutions. The best way to have the right questions during an interview is very, very simple. Every time you think of one, write it down, and over the weeks, the months, and the years, you're going to develop a fantastic library of really, really great questions to ask your customer that can just slip off the tongue really, really easily during a discovery meeting.
As we already know, our most valuable assets are, in fact, our people. As a leader, one of the best things I learned over the years was to surround yourself with the smartest people you can find and with the staff that's more talented than you, at least in key areas of your company. Keep them engaged and productive by leveraging their passions and listening to them, and more important, allowing them to do their jobs and contribute their ideas to the success of your company.
One thing I have learned over the year is if you spend more time on design thinking and designing and you make design documents properly, you have less issues at the end of any project. Client discovery is a very, very important tool to do a successful project.
So the most valuable thing I've learned over the years is that people are buying you. I know that sounds like a cliche, but what they're buying is the fact that you'll meet your promises. They're not buying stuff, everyone sells stuff. They're buying you. They need to trust you and you need to deliver. And that's the thing that helps you succeed.
I think the thing I've learned most is that being boss and being bossy are not the same, in that teamwork is absolutely everything to getting things done and getting things done well.
Back to our Best Integrated Home Awards. Here's Dee Bubeck from Crestron Australia.
For the Best Integrated Home Level 3, we've had one excellent award. So congratulations go to Len Wallace Audio for Marine Parade. Well done, guys.
This seaside beauty is an architectural marvel, and Len Wallace had to respect that look. The firm also had to anticipate the client's wishes, since the homeowner had little time for consultations. Other challenges? The customer was a technophobe, so controls had to be incredibly intuitive, and a robust and highly secure network was needed for those times when the home doubled as an office. Also, the client spends a lot of time out of the country, and requested that the system should be able to be used remotely and be simple to manage by the property management team. In addition to entertainment and control solutions, the home features automation for lighting, shading, HVAC, and more.
What an amazing honor. I'm so very thankful for this award. I'm very proud and privileged to represent Len Wallace Audio here in Sydney, Australia. It's an amazing company that I work for with a huge pedigree in the CEDIA Awards, one that we're very happy to continue this year. I'd like to thank the team here at Len Wallace. Without the support, the input, and the expertise, I wouldn't be sitting here accepting this award. I'd also like to congratulate all the other finalists in this year's awards. I know the blood, sweat, and tears you pour into these projects, and at times it's not easy. It's an amazing skill that we all share. So you should all be very, very proud of where you've come to and what you've achieved. And also, I'd also like to thank CEDIA for providing the platform, the standards, the recommended practices, all the knowledge that we need to continue producing projects of this caliber. Congratulations to everyone, and I hope to see you all next year.
After 42 years in the market, Len Wallace Audio is still a force to be reckoned with in this industry, having won more CEDIA awards than any other integrator in Australia. 2020 also marks the company founder and former CEDIA board member Len Wallace's 50th anniversary in the industry. So congratulations to the entire team at Len Wallace Audio. You know what? I think it's about time for another drink. What do you reckon, barkeep?
The next drink that we're going to make this evening for Crestron, Control Freak. We're going to grab this time a nice cold champagne coupe and start with a 50ml pour of Havana dark rum. Following that with some Cointreau orange liqueur, 25ml. Some cranberry juice. The citrus is going to be fresh lime, 35ml. And the sweetener is going to be a cinnamon syrup. And that's the final drink. And shake away. And pop the finished drink into the lovely cold glass. And we're going to be garnishing this with a little bit of vanilla frosting and a nice red cherry. For Crestron, Control Freak.
This is the 2020 CEDIA Awards Show. Who will be the recipient of this year's Lifetime Achievement Award? Stay tuned and find out.
Now, on to Best Integrated Home Level 4.
And finally, for the Best Integrated Home Level 4, the finalists are Longworth by AVD Australia of Sydney, New South Wales, Australia, and Two Villas in One by Shanghai Sentiment Electronics of China. And the winner of Best Integrated Home Level 4 is
Shanghai Sentiment Electronic Technology Company Limited for Two Villas in One. This home is, as the name implies, two residences that have been joined by a common basement. Since the homeowner is a 60-year-old woman who likes to entertain, access control is critical for security. Only approved vehicles can enter the garage, and the home features a security room safe from intruders. There's a beautiful dedicated home cinema here, enterprise-grade networking, and 5,000 lights. Music is distributed to no less than 48 zones across the properties via more than 100 speakers. The automation and integration in this home is superlative, and CEDIA's judges said that the work on the pool alone was worth an honor.
Hello everyone, I'm Daniel, the founder of Sentiment. I'm so glad that our Two Villas in One project was nominated for the CEDIA 2020 Integrated Home Awards. It was one of the biggest integrated home projects in China in 2019. And Sentiment was so proud to finish the project from the design to the system integration. It's a huge project. The two villas take 6,000 meters square and two basements were combined together as one. We installed numbers of systems in these two villas, such as security system, camera system, multi-zone audio system, home cinema system, shading system, lighting control system, etc. It's a really tough project for us because the time is limited and the huge villa. However, with the help of the staff of Sentiment and the other partners, the customer was so satisfied with what we have done. Sentiment is one of the very first CEDIA members in China as a distributor and system integrator. Last year, Sentiment got the award from CE Pro as Best Integrated Security Project, Gold. That means Sentiment reached a high level of the system integration in the world. Sentiment knows to be nominated by CEDIA is a great honor. It will help Sentiment to get more opportunities to work with the world. I would say thank you to CEDIA to give the chance to Sentiment. And I would say thank you to everyone who contributed to this project.
CEDIA members for the past 5 years, Daniel Feng and the team from Sentiment Hi-Fi, have been carving a name for themselves in high-end residential installations with a fantastic 8 cinema showroom in Shanghai. Congratulations to Shanghai Sentiment.
You're watching the 2020 CEDIA Awards. And now we'd like to tell you about a special initiative we're undertaking as part of our CEDIASTRONG campaign, the CEDIASTRONG Scholarship Fund.
I am CEDIASTRONG.
I am CEDIASTRONG.
I am CEDIASTRONG.
What a year it's been. While COVID has wreaked havoc on the world, we've been inspired by our members' grit and resolve, leveraging CEDIA and each other to build skills, resources, and opportunity. As we take stock in where we are today, we must acknowledge once again that together we truly are CEDIASTRONG. The CEDIASTRONG campaign was born from the COVID-19 pandemic and was designed to serve as a rallying cry for our industry. We're immensely proud of what we were able to accomplish together so quickly with the initiative. To date, thousands of members across the globe have participated in CEDIASTRONG events and services. And today it's my honor to announce another new program that embodies the spirit of CEDIASTRONG. CEDIA is establishing a CEDIASTRONG Scholarship Fund to eliminate financial barriers for students interested in building careers in the custom install space. I am proud that CEDIA is taking the lead attracting the next generation of our industry's labor force and providing a path to build their skills and competency. By doing so, we can offer our members trained and certified talent to support their growing businesses. The time is now to welcome young professionals to our industry. With millions of consumers working from home, the need for reliable technology solutions has never been greater. Dealerships are going to need technical professionals at all levels to meet rising demand, and we are at the ready to address this need. The CEDIA education team has spent the last 2 years revamping our education curriculum, both online and in the classroom. We now have a brand new state-of-the-art learning platform, the CEDIA Academy, that features over 50 technical business courses to guide students through pathways towards professional advancement and certification. The new curriculum is truly outstanding. Just ask the techs who've gone through the coursework thus far. And our instructional designers continue to build additional coursework for member feedback, so please check out the Academy to learn what's new and available. We're excited to fund education, coursework, travel, and certification for high potential students next year. Please help us do so by contributing to the CEDIASTRONG Scholarship Fund. Educating tomorrow's workforce will help our industry remain CEDIASTRONG. On behalf of CEDIA and the students we aim to help in 2021 and beyond, I thank you for your support.
Next up, the award for Best Auto, Marine or Aircraft, brought to you by Crestron Australia.
Hi, DB Beck again here from Crestron ANZ. In addition to sponsoring the Integrated Homes category, we're also delighted to sponsor the Liquid Automation Marine Award for... Sorry? We're not calling that? I thought we changed the name. We didn't change... Okay. Sorry. Okay. We're also delighted to sponsor the Best Auto, Marine and Aircraft category. This year's winner is a yacht called The Beast, and it's the work of... Liquid Automation, Auckland, New Zealand. Congratulations, guys.
This yacht, designed to anchor for long periods, features critical security and navigation system integration, along with networking and distributed audio and video. CEDIA's judges couldn't stop talking about this project. Here's some quotes. This is a really good job of power management. There's great cable work in this rack, especially as compact as it is. Masterful. From hidden speakers to easily controlled surveillance cameras, Liquid Automation was involved in this catamaran's build from the beginning. And the documentation really shows the complexity of this project.
Liquid Automation is humbled to have been selected to receive this award, as so many hours of design and labour have gone into this project for completion. Bruce and I would like to give a special thanks to Joel and the team who have spent many hours travelling and time away from home to create this award-winning project. Though this project had many additional challenges, as it was built in the middle of New Zealand and then shipped in two halves to a car park at Foxton Beach, which, as you can imagine, for a yacht this size, there was a lot of cables requiring rejoining. A project like this is a testament why we need good planning and documentation. And we would like to give a special thanks to the judges for selecting Liquid Automation for this prestigious award. Though, I think we're going to need a larger table.
This is the 29th CEDIA Award for Auckland-based Liquid Automation, which was founded by former submarine pilot Stephen Goodhue and former radio fitter for the Royal New Zealand Navy, Bruce Cox. The company is globally recognised as a leader in the marine sector and has won this award 11 times in the past 12 years. Congratulations, Liquid Automation. Between June 2019 and May 2020, an estimated 18.6 million hectares were burnt during an unprecedented fire season in Australia. 5,900 buildings were destroyed, including more than 2,500 homes, and 34 people lost their lives. Smoke from the fires reportedly affected the air quality in countries as far away as Chile and Argentina. It was a horrific start to the year, but some resilient members of our industry volunteered on the front line. Industry writer and AV consultant John O'Brien was just one of the many industry figures helping to fight the fires. This is his story.
Hi, John O'Brien here. You might have seen me around a bit. For the last 8 years, I've also been a volunteer firefighter with the CFA, where I'm third lieutenant and training coordinator for our local brigade. We're already preparing for the fire season that is coming. It comes every summer without fail. Some years we get lucky and don't get many call-outs, but last summer was not one of those lucky ones. It was crazy. For us, it meant week after week of monster fires on the border and beyond, mixed up with some pretty epic and scary ones closer to home. By the time it was all done, our whole brigade was sore, tired and jaded. We saw and did things that are not normal. Normal is running away from danger. As emergency responders, we drive towards it. Then we try and put out fires before they get too big. If they do, we fall back and try and contain them. But we can't do it alone, and we can't do it without knowing what we're doing. We do this to help our neighbours, local, state and national, so they might help us when it's our turn. Because it will be our turn one day. Living in the bush, we know it's not if, but when. It's not always action though. We spend more time in endless training sessions, returning from false alarms and going around in circles than anything else. And we get to drive big red trucks around the countryside with sirens and flashy stuff. It's taken a lot of field time to become a better firefighter. But I firmly believe that my gig experience has been crucial in keeping a clear head when it's all going pear-shaped. Hence why I'm already a crew leader and senior brigade member. Just like on the stage, respect on the fire ground comes from actions more than words. The reality of being a volunteer firefighter is that we take time out of our lives and out of our livelihoods. We leave our families behind and risk our own skin to keep others safe. We're not superheroes. We're just ordinary folk helping out others. We do what we do because we care enough to give a toss and because it always feels good to give. Sometimes it's scary, often it's frustrating, and it always takes way more time out of your life than you could ever think. But we do get the special rewards. The beers shouted at the pub, the thank yous from those we protected, and the respect from those who can't or won't join in. We sleep soundly, know that we've done something good for someone else. That's why we volunteer.
Coming up in just moments, one of the global winners of the 2020 CEDIA Awards is from the Asia Pacific region. We'll find out who that is. Stay tuned.
Next on our program, we present the winners in the categories of documentation and best dressed rats. Presented by Convoy International, who also provided the wine for tonight's event.
Hi, this is Steve from Convoy International. In addition to sponsoring the wine that went out to the finalists and the members of the press, we are here to present the awards for Best Documentation and Best Dressed Rack. The award for Best Documentation takes into account several factors. Is it clear? Is it thorough? And could another integrator look at the schedule and schematics and be able to either troubleshoot or upgrade the system easily using the documents? Our winner checks all the boxes. Congratulations to Boutique AV of Melbourne, Australia, for the Bespoke Art Decor Media Room.
A project of this complexity requires incredible, careful planning, and that's evidenced by this video peek at some of the work that went into the room. This project also won for Best Media Room, Level 2.
Another category and another win for the team at Boutique AV. Formed in 2013, Boutique AV has built its practice by working with several high-profile clients like Zagame's Autobody and Audi Melbourne. This year, the team's eye for detail has paid off in abundance, and it has set a new benchmark in this category for the years to come.
And now, for all you aficionados of rack porn, the award for Best Dress Rack, congratulations to the Digital Picture of Queensland, Australia, for its project, Electric Dreams.
The rack for this project, already a winner in the Best Home Cinema Level 2 category, drew quite a few compliments from our judges. The biggest challenge here was space. Terrific design allows for service and upgrades with minimal struggle in close quarters.
For those of you counting at home, this is the third award tonight for the Gold Coast-based team at the Digital Picture. A strong advocate for end-user education, Scott Sauer and his team are held in high regard by their clients, often winning jobs based on the strength of their character rather than being the lowest bid. Congratulations, Scott.
This is the 2020 CEDIA Awards Show. In moments, we'll meet the recipient of this year's Lifetime Achievement Award. But first, a few more trophies for our CEDIA member integrators.
Now let's hear about the winner, the Innovative Solution for 2020.
This award speaks to creating novel solutions to particular problems or unusual client requests that come up in the design process of completing an integration that allows the project to meet the client's expectations perfectly. The award for Best Innovative Solution for 2020 goes to Liquid Automation for their work on the Expedition catamaran yacht called The Beast.
A massive yacht, an integration that included everything from navigation and surveillance to entertainment, truly turned this craft into a seaworthy, integrated home. CEDIA's judges marveled at everything, from the media solutions to the work on the bridge, and noted the challenges of temperature and salt water that can plague these installations. Liquid Automation ticked all the boxes.
In addition to winning this award, Liquid Automation directors Stefan Goodhue and Bruce Cox were the winners of the highly coveted 2020 Golden Pole Award for the most influential person in the industry, issued by Connected Magazine and named after yours truly. It's truly a year of great accolades for this fast-moving team. Up next, Best Lighting System.
The judges found another runaway winner in this category. They were unanimous in their appreciation for the work on this top project. Congratulations, Boutique AV, once more for Bespoke Art Deco Media Room.
Light is as much a part of this media room as any other component, and the Art Deco vibe is carried into every application and fixture here. Boutique AV wins again this evening for this beautiful marriage of retro looks and modern technology.
Next, let's take a look at the architectural categories. These two new awards for Asia Pacific are judged by a global panel of architects, developers, and designers. First up, technology meets design. The Technology Meets Design Award celebrates the project that has best integrated technology to complement the design scheme of a room or home. The finalists are Boutique AV, for Advanced Hilltop Living, Boutique AV for Bespoke Art Deco Media Room, Liquid Automation for The Beast, The Digital Picture for The Bunker, and Shanghai Sentiment for Two Villas. And the winner is Boutique AV with the Bespoke Art Deco Media Room. Congratulations, Boutique AV.
Boutique AV has won multiple awards this evening for their work on this media room, which packages cutting-edge technology inside an Art Deco design scheme that is a perfect testament to the desired retro look. What's more, the integration firm preserved the integrity of the heritage home that surrounds this room.
Yeah. Now let's turn our attention to the second of the design categories, the Life Lived Best at Home Awards. The Life Lived Best at Home Award honours the project that best uses technology to maximise and enhance the client's lifestyle. These projects provide the homeowner with excellent functionality, safety, entertainment, convenience, aesthetics and efficiency. The finalists in this category are Argus Technologies for Hobson Bay, Boutique AV for Advanced Hilltop Living, Boutique AV for Bespoke Art Deco Media Room, and Len Wallace Audio for Marine Parade. And the winner is Boutique AV once again, this time for Advanced Hilltop Living. Congratulations, Boutique AV.
It's yet another win for Boutique AV, this time for an integrated home that's already been honored this evening. This trophy means that the integration firm has married tech seamlessly into the design of the residence to create an experience that's more than the sum of its parts.
Due to their incredible run tonight, forgive us if we have run out of things to say about this fantastic work this company does. There's a key award that we will be handing out tonight. This one doesn't honour a firm, but rather an individual. Let's find out who will win CEDIA's Lifetime Achievement Trophy. This award recognises an individual who's demonstrated innovative and visionary leadership in the CEDIA industry. Past recipients include some of the world's most brilliant entrepreneurs, inventors, engineers and leaders. Since it was first handed out in 1992, this award has become one of the highest CEDIA honours an individual can receive. And to introduce tonight's recipient, here's our chairman, Rob Sutherland.
It's my pleasure to introduce our Lifetime Achievement Award recipient for 2020. He's a long-time CEDIA volunteer and instructor. His knowledge in the field of video is outstanding. The man, the myth, the jacket, congratulations, Michael Heiss.
Hi there, CEDIA. Mike Heiss here, if the outfit, you know, kind of doesn't make it obvious. I wish we were together in person so that I could wear the famous jacket. They warned me to do black tie, but I think a CEDIA shirt is way more appropriate. I'm honored. I'm beyond honored to receive the Lifetime Achievement Award from CEDIA. You know, Groucho Marx once said I wouldn't belong to any club that would have me as a member. This is one club that I never thought I would become a member of, and again, I'm beyond honored to join the ranks of CEDIA founders like Tom Dougherty and Chris Stevens, the people who made CEDIA what it is today, Frank White, Eric Bodley, Bill Scare, Joel Silver, Mitchell Klein, and the people who really gave CEDIA the products and services and concepts that enable us to do what we do. Folks like Bob Stewart, Don Stewart, not related, George Felstein, Theo Kilimarakis, Tom Holman, and of course, Dr. Floyd Toole. Those are the people that really made CEDIA in many ways what it is today, and I'm really, really happy to join that list. It's like being a member of the Saturday Night Live Five Timers Club. Lifetime achievement. Look at where we've gone, and what, relatively speaking, is a relatively short lifetime in the history of audio, video, and consumer electronics. We've gone from everything being wired and only doing audio to voice command and everything, you know, internet of everything, not just internet of things, but everything through the internet. We've gone from VCR to streaming. We've gone from matrix surround to fully immersive object-based audio. We've gone from three tube projectors. I remember three tube projectors. Tom Dougherty will remind me of that. To micro LEDs. It's been a wild ride from all of those things to where we are now. And I have been a part of that, and I continue to look forward to being a part of that. When I received the Volunteer of the Year Award for my part in the Garden of HD Delights, imagine something like showing HD TV sets. Why would anybody even want to do that now? But at the time, at that point in the lifetime, it was important. And when I accepted that award, one of the things that I said was, you know, you can complain. You complain, but it won't do any good. Don't complain, because it won't do you any good. If you want to change things, be a part of it. Get involved in CEDIA activities. Become a volunteer. Help educate those who are coming up behind us. That's something that I hope to be able to continue to do for the rest of a long lifetime. And I hope that that will include seeing everybody in person very soon. Thank you very much for this award. And again, everybody stay well. And I look forward to seeing you in person much sooner than later.
At this time, we'd also like to honor our 2020 CEDIA Fellow. CEDIA has benefited from visionary leaders, passionate volunteers, and dedicated members. The CEDIA Fellows represent a group of individuals who have helped shape the industry and significantly contributed to the association's success. This year, we welcome one new inductee, Dennis Erskine. Over his career, Mr. Erskine has served as a CEDIA SME in home theater design, has participated in the joint CEDIA CTA best practices efforts, and the development of the home theater certification. He is currently a volunteer in the CEB 22 development and chairman of CEDIA's certification commission, working to acquire ANSI ISO accredited certifications. He served 7 years on the board of directors, two of which as chairman. CEDIA has benefited greatly from Mr. Erskine's dedication to the industry and the association. Thank you, Dennis, and congratulations on this well-earned designation.
Right now, we're revealing the global winner for the best media room. Winners in the integrated home, home theater, and media room categories from the Americas, EMEA, and Asia Pacific all go into the running for the CEDIA Global Awards. Judges then compare the winners to determine the overall global winner. So, congratulations once again to Batik AV for the Bespoke Art Deco Media Room, which has been named the best media room globally.
In addition to its wins for Asia Pacific Media Room Level 2, this project also picked up trophies for best documentation and lighting. Some of what CEDIA's judges had to say: nice documentation and rack work, great custom user interface, wonderful integration, very creative lighting, an incredibly innovative solution for a multi-screen Art Deco room, a tough client request that was handled beautifully.
Congratulations once more to Batik AV for your global win. Needless to say, there's no acceptance speech here from Ruben, as he wasn't even aware that this project was up for this award. You couldn't really have a better result from your first year entering the CEDIA Awards. Batik AV has now been named as the second Australian company ever to win a CEDIA Global Award, and is the first to do so in the Media Room category. Congratulations again to the entire team at Batik AV. Congratulations again to all our winners this evening. And thank you for sharing in this celebration.
We hope you've enjoyed yourself and had a few drinks.
The number of people who made this program possible is too long to mention, but we do want to give a nod to our video producers, Holston Studio, and to our bartender this evening, who has absolutely outdone himself.
I'm Wendy Griffiths, from myself and Paul Skelton. Good night, and thank you for staying CEDIA Strong.
I am 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 strong.
We are CEDIA Strong.